Dear learners, as part of the series on religion, this is our third session. The basic objective of this session is to understand the role of various religions, Sikhism, Islam and Christianity. Let me start with the word of Sikhism. The word Sikh refers to disciple or learner. This religion was founded in northern India in the 15th century by Shri Guru Nanak Dev Ji. The religion stresses on the equality of men and women. Basically, Sikhs believe in three principles. First, meditating on the name of God, that is praying, earning a living by honest means, that is sharing the fruits of one's labor with others. The religion rejects caste and class system and emphasizes service to humanity. The Sikh faith teaches us to be principles of freedom, equality and justice. This freedom is important, and today in India there are about 25 million Sikhs in the world. Sikhs have been in different parts of the world, especially in the United States for more than 100 years. Sikhism recognizes the universal truth that underlying all human endeavors, religion and belief system. The Sikh way of life reaches to people of all faith and cultural background, encouraging them to see beyond the differences and work together for world peace and harmony. Let me take you to the brief background of the emergence of this system. The Sikh faith is 500 years old. Guru Nanak, the founder of Sikhism, focused on the message of love and brotherhood. He spoke in a language which was common to all mankind, and his teachings are not limited to any nation, race, creed or gender. The Sikh religion is monolithic. It believes in one supreme creator. It is free from gender bias, focused on all pervading and eternal power. Sikhism provides us a unique opportunity to discover and develop the divinity in each one of us. Human rights and justice are cornerstone of Sikh belief system, and Sikh history features countless examples of Sikh gurus and their followers who have made tremendous sacrifice for the cause of religious freedom and justice. Sikhism is also involved in number of war-related activities, and during the both world war, Sikh followers have contributed immensely. Let me now discuss with you the concept of Sikh identity. In 1699, the 10th and the last living Sikh Guru, Guru Gobind Singh, summoned his followers to the town of Anandpur in Punjab, and around 80,000 came. According to history, Guru Gobind Singh appeared before his people, flashed a naked sword and demanded a head. He repeated his call until 5-6 volunteered. These 5 individuals came from different parts of India and were from different castes. Subsequently, this was a historical day, and Guru Gobind Singh Ji bestowed a new set of teachings to his followers, new creed of Sikhs. The Guru initiated the 5 into the order known as Khalsa, and it has a historical role to play. On that day, he gave Sikh a unique identity which includes 5 articles of faith. First, unshown hair as a gift of God and Guru and a mark of Sikh identity. Second, a small comb for the hair. Third, a steel bracelet which signifies a reality with no beginning and no end, and is also a symbolic of Sikh's commitment to ideals of faith. It indicates fearlessness and identity to Sikh religion. A sword, which is indicative of resolve and commitment to justice. And a knee-length braces, in which one has to go for a disciplined lifestyle as a Sikh. So these 6 sculptures and the various articles of Sikh religion help us to understand how to live a life based on right principles. The writings of earlier Sikh gurus along with the writings of famous gurus were compiled in a writing known as Guru Granth Sahib, which is a unique collection of spiritual writings for Sikh. Guru Granth Sahib is the repository of all spiritual knowledge and authority. All matters related to Sikh community are vested and worldwide Sikh prayer through the holy text of Granth Sahib. It helps in increasing the awareness of the spiritual heritage. Sikh revered to 10 gurus, Guru Nanak to Guru Gobind Singh, because they have delivered the divine word, the various sermons and preachings. Therefore, the word Guru has a very special meaning in Sikh literature. A person who propagates divine messages and helps the mankind to live a healthy life. In Sikhism, the place of worship is known as Gurudwara. I am sure you must have visited a Gurudwara or have understood the activities from a distance. Many times, Gurudwaras had served as a refuge for homeless and destitutes. Gurudwaras usually display the Nishan Sahib, a saffron color triangular flag behind the khanda, the symbol of Sikh faith. Visitors, irrespective of their religion, are offered shelter, comfort and food. The prerequisites for entering the Gurudwara are removing shoes, covering one's head with a handkerchief, scarf and praying. Charity is again important whenever we are visiting a Gurudwara. In a Gurudwara, no special place or seat is reserved for any dignitary. All are considered equal. The service consists of singing of various hymns, studying about Sikh history, tradition and theology. Non-Sikhs are always welcome in Gurudwara, and Gurudwaras are found all over the world. They usually run free community kitchens which provide meal for all. These kitchens are run and funded by volunteers. Along with this, let me take you to the important places of Sikh pilgrimage. Golden Temple, popularly known as Harmandir Sahib or the Darbar Sahib, is situated in Amritsar, Punjab, and is the most sacred temple for Sikhs. You can read more about Golden Temple and you will find that a lot of international tourists visit India for Golden Temple. Anandpur Sahib is the holy city of bliss and is a sacred place for Sikhs in India. It is well maintained by the authorities. In Uttarakhand, we have Hemkund Sahib, which is situated at a high altitude Lokpal lake known as Hemkund. We have Damdama Sahib, which is again a very important shrine associated with Guru Gobind Singh Ji and his visit to the place. So all these places attract lot of tourists both from India and abroad. Patna Sahib, the Sikh consider the city of Patna very holy, as their 10th guru had was born there. So you have lot of tourism activity. Paunta Sahib is also a home for tourists, and Gobind Singh Ji has stayed there for more than 4 years and he had written a Dasham Granth there. So all this indicates that Sikhism is a religion which is rich in its principles, in its theology, in its scriptures, and the concept of seva and help to the mankind is fundamental principles. Today, Sikhs are across the entire world and they are helping people and the community across the world to live a righteous life. I will now discuss with you two most prominent religions of the world, Islam and Christianity. And as a tourist professional, it is essential for you to understand the practices of both the religion, because you will be meeting guests, you will be interacting with travel operators and customers who are following these religions. So let's talk about Islam. Islam is the second largest religion in the world after Christianity. We have around 1.8 million Muslims worldwide. The date of creation of Islam is again controversial. Scholars typically date the creation to Islam to 7th century, making it the youngest of the world major religion. Islam started in Mecca, which is a part of Saudi Arabia, during the time of Prophet Muhammad's life. Today, this faith is spreading rapidly throughout the world. Now, let's discuss some of the few facts related to Islam. The word Islam means submission to will of God. Followers of Islam are called Muslims. Muslims are monotheistic and they worship all-knowing God, who in Arabic is known as Allah. Followers of Islam aim to live a life of complete submission to Allah. They believe that nothing can happen without Allah's permission. And humans have a free will, but they must devote and dedicate all the activities to the Almighty Allah. Islam teaches that Allah's word was revealed to Prophet Muhammad through the angel Gabriel. Muslims believe several prophets were sent to teach Allah's law. They respect some of the prophets from other religions, such as Abraham, Moses. Muslims contend that Muhammad was the final prophet as far as their religion is concerned. Mosques are the places where Muslims worship. Some important Islamic places at the global level are Kaaba Shrine in Mecca, Mosque in Jerusalem, Prophet Muhammad's Mosque in Medina. The Quran is the holy textbook of Islam. This is a book which propagates most of the Muslim teachings, and we find that in India it is quite popular among the followers. Followers worship Allah by praying and reciting the Quran. They believe that there will be a day of judgment and a life after death. The central idea of Islam is jihad, which means struggle. So this term has been widely used in certain literature in a negative term, but basically it stands for the internal and external efforts by the Muslims to defend their faith. This is a very important concept, and a constant war between the evil and the good takes place. Along with this, Muslims believe in the concept of praying 5 times a day. Like other religions, there are different types of Islams which denominated within the Sunni and the Shia groups. We have the Wahhabi sect, which is a Sunni sect made up of the members of the Tamim tribe in Saudi Arabia in 18th century. The followers of this tribe observe an extreme strict interpretation of Islam, which was taught by Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab. Alawit, this Shia form of Islam is prevalent in Syria. Followers hold similar belief about the caliph. There are certain other local practices that they follow. Then we have the Khiljiites. This sect broke from the Shiites after disagreeing over how to select a new leader. They are known for their radical fundamentalism. So we have various variants, but the message remains the same. Each follower visits mosque. There are certain monuments which are famous for their intricate architecture, historical significance and pride. In India, Ajmer Sharif, Jama Masjid, Fatehpur Sikri and Hasrat Bal Shrine are some of the places where millions of devotees visit to seek the blessings of the Prophet. Now, I will discuss with you some of the prominent tourist places from the Islamic point of view. The first one, as I shared, was the Hazrat Bal Shrine in Jammu and Kashmir near Dal Lake. It's an important pilgrimage site. I hope that most of you are aware about Jama Masjid, which is the largest mosque of India, one of the important places of medieval architecture. This Mughal monument is a structure with 100 domes and pillars. It's built basically for the purpose of worship. And it has a huge range of activities associated with it. Each dome is different from one another, and the Mughal Indo-Islamic architecture is reflected in this kind of a structure. On the important festival days, we find that a lot of people gather there to offer their namaz at Jama Masjid. It is one of the significant holy places of Islam in India. Jama Masjid is a prominent tourist attraction. It's part of the famous city of Shahjahanabad. Many tourists visit Chandni Chowk, Lal Qila, and also visit Jama Masjid due to its historical and spiritual importance. Now let me take you to another prominent area of devotees, that is Ajmer Sharif at Ajmer in Rajasthan. This is considered to be a holy place of Islam in India. The Dargah of Ajmer in Rajasthan is visited by both Hindus and Muslims. It is believed that no prayer at this Dargah is unanswered. The Dargah is one of the most revered shrines of Islam followers in India. It's a famous pilgrimage center where people from different religious backgrounds come to offer prayers. Not only from India, but also across the world. The Dargah reflects Muslim style of architecture. Let me just give you a brief background about Ajmer Sharif. Ajmer Sharif is a grave of Saint Khwaja Mohiuddin Chishti. Born in Chishti region in Afghanistan, Sant Mohiuddin Chishti was above the material and worldly things. In his process to teach mankind the right way of living, he came to India and he settled in Ajmer. There he attracted large number of followers, which included famous emperors and people from higher ranks. In Ajmer, he practiced the Sufi silsila, which emphasized on Hindu-Muslim unity. The Ajmer Sharif Dargah remains open from morning to late evening, and during various festivity seasons, events are organized at the Dargah. This Dargah is important because Ajmer is considered to be a place of synthesis, and as a shrine, it is one of the oldest and the biggest Dargah in South Asia. This Dargah belongs to somewhere around 13th century, and number of generations have been visiting this Dargah to pay homage. It is also known as the Dargah of Garib Nawaz, which is directly related to the Prophet himself. Khwaja Chishti was also known as Garib Nawaz due to his benevolence and hospitality towards poor. So from Delhi, we discussed Ajmer. Now another center of Muslim pilgrimage in India is the Charminar in Hyderabad. It's an impressive tourism attraction and is visited by thousands of tourists as a part of their pilgrimage. They visit the place. This place has a lot of spiritual importance. It has a mosque, and this mosque, praying there is of highly vibrant energy. It was constructed after the prayers of Sultan Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah were fulfilled regarding the suppression of plague. It is interesting to witness the way the present city is of Hyderabad has sprung up around this mosque. It's an important religious emblem attracting common people and visitors from different parts of the world. The mosque has witnessed the growth and prosperity of the city and is a well important tourism attraction of the times. In Mumbai, we have the Haji Ali Dargah. I hope you must have all heard about it. Haji Ali Dargah is important because it houses the tomb of a great Muslim saint, Haji Ali. The saint is known to have given up all his worldly possessions and went to Mecca. His selfless love and service towards the people made him a highly revered personality. More than 40,000 pilgrims visit the shrine to offer chadar and sincere prayers, and during the Urs, that is the death anniversary of the saint, and on the occasions of Eid, especially Islamic rituals are performed at the Dargah. Haji Ali Dargah is one of the most visited places of Mumbai. Saint Haji Ali had traveled the world to preach Islamic lessons, and he had been moving across the world, going towards Mecca and other places. And once his health fell drastically, he asked his followers to cast his body in a coffin in the Arabian Sea when he dies. Soon he left the world, and his followers did as they were asked. It is said that the coffin stuck on the piles of rocks, and this is where the Dargah stands today. It's a highly blessed place and is visited by a number of pilgrimage across the world. So friends, in this session we have discussed so far two different religions, Sikhism, and then we had discussed about Islam. Now I move to a religion which is the largest religion of the world, Christianity, with more than 2.2 billion followers. We all know about Jesus Christ. You must have read about him. Jesus was born approximately in 7 BC and is believed to begin his teachings in the early years of his life. Christianity is divided into number of divisions or denominations, which include the Roman Catholic, the Eastern Orthodox, and the Protestantism. But the basic principles remain the same. Those who follow Christianity believe that Jesus was crucified on the cross and was buried and was resurrected again, has a different way of life, and those who believe that he died for the forgiveness of the sin have their own ways. Now, of understanding the religion, some interesting facts about Christianity. Jesus is also referred to as Messiah or a Christ. Most Christians believe that Jesus is the Son of God and his coming was predicted in the Old Testament of Bible. Jesus' teachings and his lives are documented in the New Testament of the Bible. Christians believe that Jesus will return to the earth in the second coming of Christ, a day of judgment for humans for their sins, and will grant eternal life to those who believe and follow his teachings. In Christianity, the word gospel is used to refer to a written account of Jesus' life. The Ten Commandments are the principles of Christianity. There can be different interpretations and variations about the commandments, but the most important aspect of these is that they prohibit murder, theft, adultery, and they focus on worshipping good values and principles, practicing them in a day-to-day life. The Roman Catholic Church is the largest Christian denomination in the world. Today, Roman Catholics make up approximately half of the world's Christian population. There are approximately 800 million Protestant Christians worldwide today. Approximately 160 million of world's Christians are in following the basic principles. So we can see that there are a number of practices. There are a number of books on Christianity that are available in the market. And you find lots and lots of Bibles are distributed as a part of the religious activity across the globe. Christianity includes number of people who work for the promotion of religion. They can be bishops, they can be preachers, they can be saints who visit different places including churches, chapels, and spread the message of universal brotherhood. Church is an important place of worship. Christians believe in angels, devils, demons, and Holy Spirit, Mary, Mother of Jesus, and also in the concept of heaven and hell. Christians believe in one God, essentially in the Trinity of Holy Spirit, Father and Son. Another important aspect of Christian belief is that they consider afterlife, an eternal heaven or a hell, depends upon individual faith in God. They worship, and the important Christian events are Christmas, Good Friday, Easter, and All Saint Days. Christianity teaches universal brotherhood and to be away from seven deadly sins, including pride, greed, lust, envy, anger. Baptism in Christian faith can have different meanings. Some people believe that if we go through the process of baptism, then we become a formal member of the church, while others link it to salvation or it helps to strengthen a person's faith. So we see so many variants of Christianity. It is practiced in India and in different parts of the world, across the world, mainly practiced in North America, South America, and parts of Europe. Apart from Jesus Christ, there are a number of prominent saints which are respected, worshipped in Christianity, and their teachings are popular among the masses. In India, Christianity is spread in different parts. We find churches in all the major cities of India. We have churches in Tamil Nadu, which are prominent among the tourists. These are the religious phrases. Saint Francis Xavier, who dedicated his entire life for the growth of Christianity. In the Kanyakumari districts also, we find lot of number of places where we find Christian followers visiting. The Tamil Nadu churches hold a unique place in the historical past of Christianity in South India, and one of the important religious places to be visited during a trip to India. The next and the most important place in Tamil Nadu is also the St. Thomas Cathedral and the St. Mary's Church, St. John Church. All these are the churches of Sacred Heart are in Delhi, are some of the very, very prominent places. Along with that, we have churches in Goa, which offer us some of the insights about the development of Christianity and how it prospered on the Indian soil. So we have a lot of practices. We have number of Christian schools in India which promote the basic principles of God and help people to learn, live a life based on religious thoughts and principles. So in the end, I would like to sum up that the linkages between tourism and religion is very strong. Whichever religion you follow, whether you follow Christianity or Islam or Sikhism, it is very much related with the type of destination you wish to visit. If you are a follower of Sikh religion, you prefer to visit to famous Gurudwaras, both in India and abroad, related to the Sikh Gurus. If you practice Islamic religion, then mosque is one of the important places, and you also visit the shrines of various Sufi saints. And in Christianity, we find that churches of Goa or churches in different cities are symbols of religious practices, and tourists across the globe visit Goa or such places to gain an insightful experience about the religious aspects. Religious tourism in India is growing in a big way. We are facilitating, developing our facilities, our infrastructure, and also promoting special campaigns to conserve these historical places. These places are not only prominent from the point of view of religious importance, but they have an element of faith associated with it. Most of the tourists are mass tourists who visit these shrines, these places, to gain insight into their spiritual experience, for upliftment of the self, and for the social and community development. The architectural styles of these churches, mosques, and gurudwaras indicate a unique mixture of different architectural styles, and also provide us an insight about the synthesis of culture in India. So I hope with these classes and sessions on religion, you have understood that each tourist or a visitor to your destination is different. They have their own way of life, their own strong spiritual principles, and their travel plans and itineraries are widely dictated and influenced in terms of their religious faith. The underlying principle of all the religion is universal brotherhood, helping the community, eradication of evils, and promoting a lifestyle which is for the betterment of humanity.